crater at the top of the planet lies an icy wilderness, not of land, but of frozen water, the Arctic Ocean. Its surface forms an almost solid platform that is bigger than the whole of the United States. Its presence and condition dominates the lives of all the many and varied animals. To survive here, life must adapt to this world that alternates between ice and water. A newly emerged polar bear mother encourages her cubs to take their first tentative steps on the sea ice.
Thank you.
At the far south of our planet lies the most hostile of the Earth's frozen lands. Antarctica. Here, temperatures can fall to below minus 80 degrees Celsius. Its icy center is almost devoid of life. The wealth of life found around Antarctica's lonely islands is evidence of the richness of the waters that surround them. The Southern Ocean. Killer whales are among the most intelligent of all non-human predators. But each member of this pod needs to eat seal a day, so the pressure is on to feed. They're led by a matriarch who knows exactly what to do. But several thousands of miles further north, in the tundra, the spring thaw is only just beginning. When it does, under 24-hour daylight, its impact is even more extreme. 5 million square miles of snow disappear in a matter of days. Centimeters beneath the surface of the ground, a snow queen is waiting to make her appearance. A Lapland bumblebee. She's barely alive. All the other members of her colony were killed by the cold. She survived, as bumblebee queens do, thanks to her larger size, her particularly thick fur, and a natural antifreeze that she has in her body. As temperatures continue to rise, she begins to thaw. She vibrates her flight muscles, which raises her body temperature to over 30 degrees Celsius in just 6 minutes. There is no time to lose. She must now create an entire colony. First, a queen must find a drink of nectar to regain her strength.
Thank you. Thank you.